Have you ever thought about designing a device or a system? Well, you have come in the right place. Design in engineering is always a challenging task. However, it can make the life easier and happier for a group of people. Engineering design is the process of creating a system, component, or a process to meet specific needs. It is a decision-making process, and uses engineering sciences and mathematics to convert resources optimally, to meet an objective. For the most part, designer engineers use mathematics, materials, and engineering sciences. Also, they use engineering drawing, graphics and the verbal communicate, to clearly express their ideas. Aside from the fundamental engineering sciences which are acquired, the first study in engineering design is design process, and that is the approach we are going to know in this video. We can organize the design process in 10 stages. We are going through this process step by step. Step number 1 is recognition of the need. Then the problem will be defined. The next step is gathering of information. Step 4 is concept generation. And then concept selection. Also, we have a communication step. Then comes detailed design and analysis. Step 8 is prototyping and testing. And naturally, the manufacturing step. The last step is life cycle maintenance. The first step is to establish the ultimate purpose of the project. Usually, this is a general statement of the client's dissatisfaction with the current situation. Some key questions that you can ask to recognize the need are like these. What is wrong about this device or system? How can it be done in a better way? How do you feel about this process and why? For example, one can say, the washing machines usually sounds very low in high speed rotation. This is a general statement that does not comment on the design approach. It does not say that the washing machine should be less vibrant or more soundproof. Understanding and phrasing the need are usually very creative acts, because the need may only be a sensing that something is not right. For this reason, sensitive people are generally more creative. Well, defining of the problem. This is one of the most critical steps of the design process. There is an iteration between the definition of the problem and the recognition of need steps. Usually the true problem is not what it first seems. The problem definition is more specific than recognizing the need. For example, if the need is for cleaner air, the problem might be that of lowering the discharged dust from a power plant, or reducing the pollution from automotive exhausts. The problem definition must include all the specifications for the thing that is to be designed. Anything which limits the designer's freedom of choice is a specification. It is essential to write a formal problem statement, which says what the design is to accomplish. This formal statement should include objectives and goals, like what must or must not be done. Also, it should include constraints. For example, consider an indoor mobile vehicle. The problem statement could be something like this. Design a vehicle which can maneuver in an indoor environment. The vehicle will be operated via remote control and must be able to travel up to a speed of 14 meters per second on a flat, horizontal, and dry concrete surface. Total vehicle weight must be less than 125 kilograms. Climb 15 centimeter high stairs at speeds up to 4 meters per second. Carry a payload of at least 10 kilograms. Fit through doorways. Travel in any direction. And so on. There are many design specifications which depends on the design field. Here we have listed some of them. The third step in design process is gathering of information. Usually, no information is easily found, or sometimes there is no information. And gathering of information is a never-ending process for the best design engineers. Information can be found in textbooks, trade journals and magazines, technical reports from government-sponsored R&D, company catalogs and reports, technical personnel, and so on. Key questions in gathering information are: where to find it, how to get it, how accurate is the information, when do I have enough information, and so on. The fourth step of design process is concept generation. This is the most creative part of the design process. In this step, based on the design specifications and gathered information, we generate some concept designs. There are several considerations for this step, which varies based on the design field. For example, a mechanical engineer designer should always be aware about symmetry and concept generation. Some general approaches to concept generation are: adaptation, area thinking, brainstorming, involvement, inversion, and so on. They are effective methods to increase the creativity in a structural way. If the designer has followed these steps thus far, he or she is now quite familiar with the problem. Many solutions have been found, but may not be quite satisfying. Having worked to this point, the designer's mind is in a receptive condition and will instantly find a solution. The problem is to link a gap between two groups of ideas and to make an association of ideas. It is generally conceded that this association occurs by pure chance. This event is more likely to occur when the problem is being discussed with another person or group of persons. The next important step to design a product is concept selection. For this purpose, usually, we form a decision matrix to evaluate different ideas based on objectives. The decision matrix contains one column for each design concept. To form a decision matrix, one can begin by selecting the objectives of design. Then, assign weighting factors based on how important each objective is to the overall success. The parameter column lists the units for each objective, and magnitude is the assigned value of each objective. Also, each concept receives a score. Score is the relative comparison of the different magnitudes. The best magnitude always receives the highest score. Value is simply the weighing factor times the score for a particular conceptual design. At the end, the overall value determines which concept is the best and should be selected. For example, consider a crane hook. The designer found three ideas that are as follow: welding plates together, riveting plates together, and casting. Here, you can see the concept selection table for each idea. And we have the score assignments for the qualitative objectives. In this way, we can use logic to rationalize qualitative parameters. The purpose of the design is to satisfy the needs of the client. That's why the communication is a must-to-do step. Designer must provide oral and written design presentations, and continuous communication is important in order to avoid surprises. Many great designs and inventions have been lost simply because the designer was unable or unwilling to explain his or her opinions to others. There are only three forms of communication available to us: written, oral, and graphical. The successful design engineer will be technically master in all three. And we all know that competency only comes from practice. Ability in writing can be acquired by writing letters, reports, memos, and papers. It doesn't matter whether the articles are published or reviewed, the practice is the important thing. Ability in speaking can be obtained in educational, civic and professional activities. To have drawing ability, pencil sketching should be employed in every possible situation. And CAD work should complement this, but not replace it. In this step, we analyze the selected concept by going through its detailed drawing and modeling. The main goal of your engineering studies is to enable you to create mathematical models, which accurately simulate the real physical world. All real physical systems can be very complex. Creating a mathematical model of the system means we are simplifying the system to the point that it can be analyzed. The terms rigid body and concentrated force are examples of accepted simplifications. However, the model must be meaningful. It is the rule in making such assumptions. And remember, a good and appropriate model always involves the design constraints. Prototype development is a key process to develop a successful product. It is a challenging task to create profitable and economically viable manufacturing solution in a competitive global market environment. To develop an outstanding product, it is important that design is validated through developing some prototypes. Also, it is important to consider that prototype development can be an expensive and time-consuming task. It is like a first-time trial, as there is no pre-established technique or process. Besides, engineers have to deal with errors, trials, and mistakes throughout the production process. When the prototype performance has been approved, the next step is designing manufacturing process for mass production, based on the required amount of product for clients and potential market. Manufacturing is a value-adding process, allowing businesses to sell finished products at a higher cost over the value of the raw materials used. If the designed product does not have the manufacturability specification, this stage cannot be done, and the design concepts should be reconsidered. The last step of a successful design process is planning a life cycle maintenance. Life cycle maintenance is a collection of methods and standards for improving maintenance, supporting and management processes throughout the life cycle of a product. This last stage of designing is a long-term task. The four key stages of the product life cycle maintenance are planning, acquisition, operation, and disposal. These stages are essential to improve the potential services of a product and minimizes the costs and involved risks. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, when it comes to design steps in engineering, we are just scratching the surface. So, subscribe and share our YouTube channel to see what content will help you for next. We will see you back here. With iDesign, we are helping you to make a successful design journey.